If you're looking for a free FL Studio alternative, LMMS might be the free DAW for you. In this video, I'm going to do an LMMS review and a quick tutorial, and we'll find out if this is a decent free FL Studio alternative. And if you have no idea what FL Studio is, or you've never used it before, you should still check out this video, as it's a great piece of music making software that will easily get you started in beat creating and music production. Welcome to Simple Green Tech. I'm Radio Zane, and on this channel, I do audio tech tips, tutorials, and reviews to help you unleash your creativity. Now, FL Studio is a great DAW. In fact, it was the first digital audio workstation that I purchased quite a few years ago. But I can appreciate that it might be a little expensive for some users who are just starting out, and you might be looking for a free FL Studio alternative to get you started in beat making and making music. LMMS is the closest free digital audio workstation that really compares to FL Studio. And once you get used to the user interface, you're going to find out that it's quite easy to start making beats and creating music in LMMS. One of the biggest and only negatives that I have to say about LMMS is that you can't record audio into it directly. You have to record audio in a separate program like maybe Audacity or some other audio recording program. However, I know that when I'm using FL Studio or now LMMS, I'm not using it for its audio recording anyway. I'm actually going to be using it because of how easy it is to start making beats and start making music inside the box, meaning using virtual instruments. And really, that's the only negative here with LMMS. And I'm sure as it continues to evolve, they're probably going to be adding audio recording into it eventually. I know in the early days of FL Studio, it wasn't the greatest at audio recording, which is one of the reasons why I moved on to other DAWs. When you first open LMMS, it will look similar to this. You have a couple of tracks already populated. You can see they even have an instrument that has an orange slice on it, similar to FL Studio's Citrus plugin. I like to remove all these tracks and just start new. Okay, so we now have this empty project. What do we do? Well, LMMS does include some of their own instruments, and you can mess around with those if you like. You just click over here on this icon, and you'll see a list of instruments. Now you can just drag and drop an instrument over into the song editor area, and you just click here to see the interface for that instrument. Now you can change any of the settings that you want in here. Personally, I prefer to use third-party VST instruments. And to do this, you first want to make sure that LMMS has your default VST plugin folder set up correctly. So let's first go up to Edit, then go into Settings, and then you want to click on the folder icon right here. And then you look for where it says VST plugin directory. You want to make sure that this is your default VST plugin folder. And for me, this was set up by default, and that is my default VST plugin folder for 64-bit plugins. If you're using the 32-bit version, it should have your 32-bit plugin folder there. Just make sure this is the right one that you use. This folder is typically where 64-bit plugins will install to, so you may not have to change anything here. If you do have to change anything, you would just click on this folder here, and then you would find wherever your folder is. Then click OK to get out of there. If you don't have any third-party VST plugins already, you can download free ones from all over the internet. One of my trusted sites that I use is pluginboutique.com. They have a decent selection of free plugins, and they often have great deals on premium plugins. I'm going to link to them in the description below, just in case you want to check them out and start building your VST plugin library. And now that you have your VST folder set, you can now bring in a VST instrument to get started with making our music. I'm going to bring in a synth plugin first, and what you want to do to add a VST plugin to your song editor is click on the instrument icon again here, and then you want to go down to Vestige and drag that in. Then click here to open the user interface, and right here where it says no VST plugin loaded, click on the folder icon. And this should bring up that default VST plugin folder that you set earlier. If it doesn't, you can also search for the folder the same way you would search for the folder in Windows Explorer. Now find the plugin that you want to use and double click on it. I'm going to use Contact Player here. This is a free plugin from Native Instruments that you can download. And you can see after I double clicked on it, the user interface for that plugin has popped up. And if you have a MIDI keyboard and you want to get it to work, you can just click on this gear icon here, go down to MIDI, click Input, and you can click on your MIDI keyboard here, and that should enable it. If you don't see your MIDI keyboard there, you may have to download this software from CoolSoft. It's called MIDI Mapper, and that's going to set your MIDI keyboard as the default for Windows. So then programs like LMMS will know to use your keyboard. This is a free piece of software. I'll link to it below so you can download it if you need to. And if you don't have a MIDI keyboard, don't worry about that. You can actually use your computer keyboard keys to play notes, just the same way you can do that in FL Studio. And personally, this is a feature of FL Studio that I really enjoy when I'm on my laptop and I don't have my MIDI keyboard connected. It can help you to quickly find a synth sound and get started with creating music. And of course, if you don't want to do that and you don't want to use a MIDI keyboard, you can choose to draw your notes in. And to draw your notes or to record MIDI notes, you have to open the piano roll. And to do that, we'll just double click right here. And here's our piano roll. This is where you'll start to develop your songs. So let's first go over some of the controls quickly that you're going to see here. And the first controls are your transport ones. So this will play. This will record notes from the MIDI keyboard or your computer keyboard without playing anything back from the song editor timeline. So you're just going to be recording into the piano roll without hearing anything played back. Now, if you want to hear all the other tracks played back, if you have other tracks, you would use this record button right here. And this will play back everything in the timeline, plus record your MIDI keyboard. Then, of course, we have our pencil tool, where we can draw notes in and drag them around. You have your erase tool. And with this, you can click to erase. Or if you don't want to use that, you can actually just with the pencil tool selected, you could right click on a note, and that's going to get rid of it. Then over here, we have our selection tool, and this can select a large group of notes. So you can move them all around together or delete them all together, whatever it is you want to do. And again, you don't need to click on this tool to use it. With the pencil tool clicked, you can actually hold down Control on your computer keyboard, then click and drag, and you have your selection tool. Beside that, there is also this detune mode. And if you click on this icon, then you click on a note, this will allow you to adjust frequencies of an individual note. This may not work for all types of instruments though, but you can try it out if you want to do this sort of thing. Beside that, you have your quantize button here. So by default, it's set to 1/16th, and that's where you're going to quantize to. Now you can change that to anything you want here. You can have it set to the half note. So if we change it, then press the Q, it's going to go to the closest half note. And beside that, you have your cut, copy, and paste. And then right here, you have your enable and disable auto scrolling. So if you're recording long, it's going to automatically scroll. You can turn that off if you want. And then right here, this controls what happens after you stop playing or stop recording. You could have it set to go back to the beginning of the clip once you stop playing, or you could have it set to go to wherever you started playing from after you stop, or you can have the cursor stay at wherever you stopped it. On the next row here, you have your zoom control, and this controls how zoomed in you are on the notes. Then you have the quantize controls that we looked at earlier. And after that is the tool that controls how the draw mode works. If you have it set to last note, then it's going to draw the same as the last note that you either drew or that you clicked on. You can also set it to one of the presets here. I like to leave it on last note. And you can choose the scale of your song if you like. Also, if you want to draw in chords automatically, you can choose a chord here. So let's just choose a major chord and then we'll draw it in here. You can see it drew in a chord automatically. And you can change that however you want. I'm just going to delete everything here and now I'm going to draw in a quick beat. All right, so now we can add some drums to our song. And we're going to do the same thing that we did before. We're going to click on the instrument plugins icon here. Then we're going to drag and drop the Vestige instrument into the song editor. Click in there, and click on the folder here. This time I'm going to add the free drum plugin called Beat Factory Drums. And you can grab this free plugin from Plugin Boutique. I've linked to Plugin Boutique in the description below, so you can check that out if you like. Now we'll open up the piano roll, but this time I want to record my beat using my MIDI keyboard. So what you'll want to do is click on the gear icon, go to MIDI, input, and make sure it's set for your MIDI keyboard. And what you can do is actually hold the control button down on the clip and drag to create a duplicate of it. And you can do this several times if you like. I'm going to do that to create a bit longer of a pattern here so I have something to record over. And you'll want to make sure that they're moved over by one bar so you get one bar counted in before you actually have to start recording. So make sure your metronome's clicked on so you have that nice click track. And don't worry about having this moved over one bar. You can always move everything back later on. I'm now ready to start recording. So let's go into the piano roll. And I want to use this record button so I can hear the clip that I played before while I'm recording. So let's press that now. All right, and there we have a little bit of a drum beat. And I'm just going to quantize it to the quarter note. Now let's listen to what that sounds like. And that's a fairly basic beat. If I wanted, I can actually add some hi-hat to that. I could either choose to draw it in here, or I could actually record over top of everything and add the hi-hats in that way. So let's try that. So now our basic drum beat is a little bit more of an actual drum beat. You could still add more in there and mess around with it. And that brings me to the next thing I want to show you, which is down in this section of the piano roll here. It's the note velocity. And if it doesn't say note velocity here, it could say note panning. You just want to click right there and change it to note velocity. And what this does is it allows you to change how hard or how soft each note is. And this can help to bring a more human feel to your beat or to your playing. And now we have our synth line and we have our beat, and we can actually loop these over and over again by holding down control, dragging, or you can right click, copy, and then right click over here, paste. And you can do that as much as you want. And you can even add your next section in, which has a little bit of different MIDI information. And to add another MIDI clip onto the same track, you would just double click into an open spot here. It's going to create a new piano roll, and you can either draw in your notes or play them in on your MIDI keyboard or on your computer keyboard. And you can choose to arrange everything around however you want in the timeline here. So now that we have our beat, we might want to edit things up a little bit by adding some effects or maybe using the mixer to adjust the levels. So let's click right here on the mixer icon to bring up the mixer view. And you can see we have a master fader already loaded in there, but no other mixer channels are loaded. So we're going to have to add two more in for our two instruments. So we'll just press plus and plus. Now we have two more. And to route our instrument to each of these, we'll just click here to bring up the interface. And then where it says effects here, you want to click, then drag up until it says one. So this is going to be on one. And then this one, we're going to click, drag up, and now it's on two. So let's bring up the mixer again. Now when we play back, you can see that there's some levels in the mixer, and we can adjust those however we want. You can also rename the channels if you want. You just double click right here, and we're going to name this bass. Then we'll name this one drums. Now we can add effects to the effects chain. Just click there to enable it. And then down here, you want to click on add effect. And LMMS actually comes with quite a few. You can see them, these LADSPA ones. And you'll also see some others that say LMMS. So you might have some here already, even if you didn't have any loaded before. But of course, you can also access all of your VST effects here that you might have loaded on your computer as well. So I'll load up an effect here. Now let's hear how that sounds. You click the controls button here to bring up the user interface for each effect. And you can adjust the effect however you want. And if you don't like an effect that you've added, just right click on this area here and click on remove this plugin. So now let's say that our song is finished and we just want to render it down to an audio file so we can post it online or maybe send it to our friends or whatever it is that we want to do with it. All we have to do is go up to File, and then you want to click on Export, not Export Tracks. What that will do is export each track individually into audio files. And that can be useful if you're going to be bringing this into another program for editing or sending individual instruments audio to somebody so they can edit it or use it for something else. But what we're going to be doing is just clicking on Export. And then you would just give it a name here. And you can also choose what file type you want to save it as. You have WAV, compressed OGG, or compressed MP3. I'm going to click on MP3. Normally I would save as WAV. I'm just going to click on MP3 to show you some of the settings. After you click save, you can edit some of the settings here and choose your different bitrate for your MP3. And you can also change this back to WAV if you decided you didn't want to go with MP3. You can change your sample rate and the bit depth if you want. Once you're ready, you would just click Start. You should now have your song in an audio form once it's done rendering. Now, we've been comparing LMMS to FL Studio, which it's very similar to, but I'm going to take this one step further and actually make it look like FL Studio. There is an FL Studio theme that was created by an LMMS user named Hacktone. I think I'm pronouncing it correctly. He spells it a little bit different, but I think it's supposed to be Hacktone. So if you go on to the LMMS forum, you can actually find a link to this. Then unzip it. Then copy the whole folder into Program Files, LMMS Data Themes. And you just want to copy that whole folder into there. Once it's in there, go back into LMMS, go to Edit, Settings, click on the folder icon here, then scroll down to where it says Themes Directory. You want to click on the icon right here and change the theme to ImageLine Fruity Loops. Select this folder, click OK, and it's going to tell us to restart it. So let's do that now. If you look at it now, some of the icons look very similar to FL Studio's icons. I know the Hacktone guy says that he's working to make it look even closer to FL Studio, so keep watching for updates to this if that's something you want to do. And if you want to go back to the other theme that we had, you would just click on the folder, scroll down to the themes directory, click on the icon there, and change it to default. Click OK, restart LMMS. And it's back to the way it was before.
Honestly, LMMS is a great piece of software, in my opinion, for anyone that wants to start making music or creating beats in a similar workflow to FL Studio, but you don't quite have the money to invest in FL Studio yet. Don't get me wrong, FL Studio is a great program and it has some more advanced features than this program has, but if you're just starting out, you're likely not going to use those advanced features or need them anyway. Plus, I have a feeling that the more LMMS continues to grow, the more features it's going to add, and the closer it's going to get at being the perfect FL Studio alternative. Let me know in the comments below if you use LMMS and what you think of it. And if you have any questions about this software, please ask in the comments below. I may do some more tutorials on this software if there is a demand for it. Now click this video up here for my three favorite free VST instrument plugins, or click this one down here to see what YouTube recommends you watch next. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also, subscribe to the channel if you'd like to see more videos from me. For Simple Green Tech, I'm Radio Zane, and we'll talk soon.